Why did the creator construct a universe teeming with imperfection, misery, sin? Among the scholars of both heaven and hell, this query is known as the Riddle of Sorrows. If sin is itself a part of the grand design, is not sin then, by definition, divine? A question for the sages. Though one particularly restless bunch kept a robust relationship to the topic. The Nephilim. Spawn of angels and demons. Warriors. Relentless. Unstoppable. Blood mad. Until they were betrayed by four of their own. War, death, fury, and strife. The four horsemen of the apocalypse. Inconceivable power was bestowed upon the traitors by those sworn to maintain symmetry twixt order and chaos. The Charred Council. Bear witness as the council holds court to end the Nephilim War in the name of balance. This is the new pact. War, bringer of worldwide fire, you are the juggernaut of all pain. Death, dark soul of eternity, you are the deepest decay. You are empty life. Strife. Endless spirit of timeless unrest. You are all that is unsettled in the hearts of that which lives and breathes. And finally, fury. Terrible engine of rage. You are the machine that...
Are we to wait? waste our time on ceremony, or are we to fight?
Step forward and recognize, horseman. You are the most impatient of your kin. The least predictable, dancing on the edge of your own reality. Your brothers understand the undertaking set before them. But do you?
Still talking? Shall I have Death fetch us some tea, or can we get on with it?
Fury, your role in this story is yet to be written. I wonder, will you light the flame of creation anew, or stomp out the embers for good?
Dreams more thrilling than reality.
Had I known the new pact would be so exciting, I would have let war separate my head from my neck then and there. Is it possible to die of boredom? Rampage. Bored as I am, perhaps you're just lazy. If I didn't love you so much, I'd kill you just for something to do. The call? Finally. Please, please, please tell me you're a planet of demons that needs slaying. Or two. War. What pathetic fate have you brought upon yourself, brother?
Watch your tongue.
I may be least favored of all the horsemen, but my tongue never found me chained to a rock like some dog.
Fury, approach us.
I take it there is a mess that needs tending to.
Though you jest, you speak true. War has broken his vows to this council, and shattered the Seventh Seal.
The Apocalypse. Why would he...
We know not. Yet. As we speak, Earth falls beneath the spears of Heaven and the hammers of Hell.
So the horsemen are to ride.
No. While the Char Council seeks to understand how and why the traitor war has committed this abominable act, there is a matter that requires delicate attention.
You should have called Strife. He's the delicate one.
The seven deadly sins have been released, by whom we cannot say, but the seven roam the earth, free of our prison. The balance between order and chaos is already in jeopardy. The Seven cannot be left unchecked. War is in chains. Death is missing. Strife attends to other matters. The last time you faced the sins, it required all four of you.
I can handle those fools in my sleep. But when this task is complete, I demand that you grant me my rightful place leading the horsemen.
For a title, so be it. But never make a demand upon us, horsemen. You depart immediately.
Greetings, Miss Fury. I must admit, this is a fortuitous fate.
A watcher? You doubt my allegiance?
Please, be not cross. I am such an admirer. Scratch that. I'm a fan. You are the horseman. The only one that matters.
Enough! I will allow you to accompany me. Just stay out of my way.
I will be as unto a shadow. Steadfast. Silent.
More silence!
Go! Seek out the place called Haven. Your quest for the Seven Deadly begins there.
Fury, wait.
Whatever has passed between us, search your heart. You cannot believe I am guilty of these crimes. Something is wrong with the universe. Be vigilant, Fury. Forces conspire against us. Heed my words!
I just know it. I hope it's not envy. That was a terror. Thank you.
haven. A haven for what, vermin?
Humans, mistress.
Adorable. Build a house of sticks during the end of the world. Where exactly do we go from here, Watcher?
I know not but what the Council commands, mistress. The quest for the Seven begins here.
Envy.
Mine! Humans, Haven, everything here! Mine! Move on, horsemen, or ye be mine too!
I'm on a mission.
Protecting humans? Humans think creation favors them. They are apes, crawling through dirt.
Quite the grudge you're carrying.
What they have, I will take. When they have nothing left, they will be my playthings until they break. You cannot stop me!
Oh, I don't want to. Humanity is tragically overrated. I am not here for them. I'm all yours.
No!
Thank you.
love was mine!
I'm not hard!
better than I imagined.
Pretty. Come and get it.
Ah, that's mine!
Mistress, not to be a bother. But weren't you supposed to catch Envy?
I did. Watch. This talisman.
It's a vessel. Envy used it to hold energies from the rest of the Seven.
It will make a fitting prison for the others once their physical forms have been broken.
If I may, there is a... well, a sort of hum emanating from the talisman. That glow...
will indicate when one of the Seven is nearby. I know.
So wise. You are all that the Council promised, Mistress.
I'm beginning to enjoy the sound of your voice, Watcher.
I would be remiss in my duties if I didn't point out that even with the talisman, locating the other deadly sins will prove a challenge.
Finding Envy was easy enough.
That was a gift. One I would not count on receiving twice. Envy was also, by far, the weakest of the deadly sins.
Anything else to add?
Only what I assume you already know. The armies of both Heaven and Hell have cordoned off the world of man into various areas of influence. Look around us. The upheaval we have seen is the very personification of the struggle between order and chaos. You have set for yourself an unenviable task, given these environs.
That's what makes it fun. The other sins are hiding across this shattered world. They strike at angels and demons alike in their own selfish bids for power. Their hubris will lead me right to them.
Perhaps you will need assistance.
Whatever I need, I will take, Watcher. I knew that war would one day unleash all this, but seeing it, his gifts are impressive.
May I remind you, Mistress, that you have your husband.
Oh!
Perhaps there are human survivors.
Not my concern. It's impressive. But is it just me, or is it out of place here?
It is a maker tree. Most likely we will find refuge there.
Aren't we making a mighty ruckus?
Says the demon who announces his ambush.
It was not my intention to do battle, horseman. Well, such a passionate little thing, aren't we?
Do not test my patience.
Very well. War is too hazardous an occupation for myself, horseman. I am here in the name of blind capitalism. I am Volgrim. Merchant of the Damned, a trader who deals in souls for profit. Even in the face of the apocalypse, one must endeavor to earn a living.
And whose souls do you trade in?
Angel, demon, or even human. All souls have value to me. I've seen the trail of bodies you've left in your wake.
What would I require from you?
That depends. What are your needs?
Information. The seven deadly sins.
Whispers on the wind say that the fabled horsemen are but pawns in a larger game. Victims of a grand setup.
What do you know?
I know that the first one's free. Call for me if you have souls to trade, and perhaps you will consider my wares valuable. This, as you wish. This will be fun for both of us. As you wish. Take your time. As you wish.
Fulgrim and his demon tongue. They live to confound and feed of the scraps of a world they helped destroy.
Indeed they do.
But despite his thirst for souls, Fulgrim may be a useful tool on this journey.
Thank you.
The length these roots have grown. They seem to have taken over everything.
Indeed, Mistress. I'm curious as to who remains here, if anyone.
What would you ask of this? This will be fun for both of us. As you wish.
Let me tend to our uninvited guests. A horseman?
Fury, currently reserving the right to kill you where you stand. And you are?
Surprised, and more than a little relieved. Call me Ulfane Blackhammer.
So, you'll not be flattening me today?
Hmm.
A maker, are you not?
Aye. when there's something to make. Today, my skills are only aimed towards instruments of death.
This is not your war.
No, not theirs neither. Like your council, I care for balance, horsemen. Humans, frail as they be, are part of the balance. Surely you're here to help protect them.
Wrong question.
A tribe of useless, hairless simians whose greatest talent was inventing ingenious new ways to divide and destroy one another. They could suffer forever or die tomorrow, and I wouldn't bat an eye either way.
And what is your business here?
What do they call you?
Jones.
Jones. Question me again with your last breath.
Look around. Look what's happened here. Do you honestly think anything scares me now?
Easy, lad. This one's none for trifles.
Yeah? What do I have to lose? This moronic conflict makes you all look so stupid. Angel, demon, horseman, even maker. What are you even fighting for, huh? Tell me!
I like this one. You may continue breathing, Jones.
Horseman, please. To have you on our side would turn the tide in ways we cannot measure. Humanity might stand a chance.
While my mission does involve balance, it does not require them. I am here to root out the seven deadly sins and return them to the Council. No less, no more.
What if I can help you? That better chain you carry could use some work.
I sincerely doubt that. I'm faring quite well without any help.
Of course. But in case you missed the moniker, I am a maker who specializes in instruments of destruction, chaos, and the deliverance of pain. So it stands to reason that wee little Ulthane could enhance your arsenal if your horsemanship would give me the chance.
In exchange for?
Humanity will not survive without aid. If you come across any humans on your journey, please direct them here. Haven is the only place they might be sufficiently protected.
Direct them? How do you expect the apes to cross a battlefield and find you?
Oh, I don't. They'll need this, the bridge. Only humans can use it. One touch, they're sent to Haven.
Must I touch them? I accept your offer, Maker. No, I doubt it will make your collection any less useless.
We have a non-deal, then. As a show of good faith, a gift. Wrath.
Where?
You seek a pit of Hellstretch set in the Nether, beneath the city. And please, horsemen.
Yes, yes, I will shepherd the wee ones your way, pointless as it may be.
We'll see. And remember, Fury, the doors of Haven stand open to any who ask.
Well met, horseman.
I bid you welcome.
Huh?
glad I'm not out there anymore.
He is certainly committed to his cause.
Ulthane, he is blind to what truly matters.
Perhaps, yes.
Just another pawn who will never understand the game into which he's been played. And he does love the sound of his own voice, doesn't he?
Not like anyone I know.
Did you say something?
Thank you.
Stop your blubbering, human. Come to me.
Now!
Do you want to live?
What?
If you want to live, I can send you to a safe place. Safe as any, I suppose. Touch it. Idiots. It's a miracle they ruled the Earth for as long as they did.
Let's go.
Oh, it smells like death in here. Trust me, we shared a room 1,000 years ago.
What? This will be fun for both of us. As you wish, take your time. As you wish. Farewell for now. Let's go.
Being observant is literally in your name, Watcher.
Thank you.
Sloth. I heard tales, but truly, he is a terrible sight to behold. I think I may be sick.
Greetings. Take your time. An excellent choice. I knew you couldn't resist. As you wish. This will be fun. As you wish. Take your time. A wide as you wish. Greet. Farewell for now.
The worst of the smells come from above.
Yeah.
To face the world itself is only for a brief time, before their inevitable destruction.
Don't dislocate your arm patting yourself on the back. How... How do you plan on dealing with that, my bloodthirsty mistress?
Music to my ears.
Feel the burn of heavy blade!
She does enjoy dismembering angels.
We all need a hobby.
I hope you've left something for me. I'll try not to enjoy this too much.
Final crawl waits.
Oh, that is unfortunate.
Disappointing.
Give me your Thank you.
summons you, we ride! We were set up. War. The others. There are great forces at work here. Watcher, help.
Mistress!
Something is wrong with the world.
Delicate order is imbalanced. Step forward. Now I ask of both angel and demon, do you arrive here of your own free will? The tenants of the Hollowing demand it.
I do, Lord of the Hollows.
As do I. You have both fought this war since the dawn of time. You are weary. Yet, immortality prevents the ultimate respite. The Lord of the Hollows alone can bestow upon you this gift. The final release. No longer will your souls be recycled time and time again to fight for heaven and hell. They are now mine. And you are finally free!
Cowards!
Ah, the impetuous creature awakens. Deluded pawn of the Charred Council. Do you even know where you are?
I know exactly where I am. The stench betrays you. The Hollows is a hell all its own.
Indeed. But it is one that I alone rule.
What did you do to them?
Nothing that they did not wish for. You wear your ignorance on your face. The true consequences of this so-called war for balance are beyond your comprehension. Perhaps I should hollow you. A watcher. This only confirms what I already held to be true. You are just a puppet. The Council is playing you to further their own machinations.
Enough! Unlike you, I have not come to this place for personal gain. The seven deadly sins must be eliminated once and for all to protect the balance you mock. I will not be deterred.
She speaks the truth, O Lord, and she is tenacious to say the least.
Your words carry no weight with me. They stink of lies.
Thank you. This is more than a test of battle.
A demonstration, horseman. You are so quick to combat. Your whip ready to crack. True righteousness requires true insight. If this was a test, you have failed. To resist a call to raw impulse is a different type of strength.
Spare your wisdom. I know my strength, and when I prove it to the Council, I alone will lead the horsemen. The Seven will be destroyed, along with their designs for a world far more hideous than the apocalypse we already know.
Very well. You will need this.
A flame hollow? For what purpose?
Even I am aware that there are times when sides must be chosen. Take this weapon, and know that I have chosen mine. But take heed, horseman. The universe has so many faces. Your survival depends on what you have learned here. You must open your eyes to much more than that which gazes back at you from the mirror.
Fine. Can we go now?
Not quite yet. There is the matter of Abraxas to discuss.
Abraxas.
The demon meddler. If Earth is to remain intact, he must be dealt with. He threatens your balance. His very soul must be brought to me.
I see. And you want me to do it?
Who better?
I'll consider it. No guarantees.
Then you and your watcher, be gone.
Fire hum. Something changes when I hold it. I can feel the power coursing through my hands. I feel nothing. Like wading through a pond.
To pay me a visit.
None of your concern, Deep. That's no secret. But by who?
Surely angels are the most likely suspect. Wouldn't you agree after what happened to dear old Rampage?
You are not fit to speak his name.
No need to unleash your might on me, horseman. Look to those who would benefit from your failure. Your enemies are closer than you. This will be fun for both of us. As you wish. This, as you wish. Farewell for now.